description came up that on the first album, second album, Strangers, that you guys were invited to a party, and you played the party. And now on Pins and Needles, you guys
are the party.
We are the party? Well, that's good.
That's fair.
I like that.
Yeah.
Are we supposed to kind of extrapolate on that?
Well, I think to sort of run off of Adam's amazing metaphor there.
Okay. I'll let you run with
this. I don't know about you, but when we were writing Walking with Strangers, we were just sort of, we'd been starting to tour for a little while, and so we were sort of getting to know that part of things, and I think at this point when we were doing this album, we're used to touring. We are the party, as you said.
I'm glad
just trying
that you
to, honestly,
it.
Does that know. Even make sense?
I don't think so.
He's, yeah.
Good.
Does that make sense? I think we wrote it coming from a different place, like sort of, instead of like sort of looking ahead and trying to figure out what, you know, touring even really is, because at that point we toured for a few years, but now, you know, we've immersed ourselves in it. We sort of know what our niche is, so we're more, yeah. I don't know what my niche is, never mind.
Well, I don't know if you guys have so much found your niche as you have created it.
Become the niche. All right, fair enough.
For the songs are just the things that were sort of happening around us and the stuff that we sort of felt like that sort of, I think anything that's sort of negative has an effect on you, and that's usually what's on your mind. I mean, usually when personally, like when I'm feeling positive and happy and everything's great, I'm kind of I'm more likely to just go sort of do something lighter and go hang out somewhere or whatever. I find usually if I'm, you know, if there's things in your life that are sort of a little more extreme or intense in a negative way, it sort of makes you a little more, either get out of your system, it makes you a little more reflective, and I think that's when you start to, like any, like, angst-ridden kid, you just start to, what is it, that's when you start the dark
poetry.
That's
when you write your poetry, right?
Your dark poetry in high school, the angsty kid.
Yeah, that's...
My mom and dad are, they just don't understand.
Right?
Parents just don't understand.
Yeah.
It's like Fresh Prince, you know? I think I
you don't really need to, like, get out your happiness, right?
Well, in that, the one line that sticks out in my head off the entire album is, like, a finger down the back of your throat. what frame of mind are you in when you string those words together?
A lot of it's just kind of train of thought, I think, and especially when we're writing lyrics, it's sort of, we'll start with the vibe of the song, and then we'll either try and offset it, or we'll sort of, you know, Chibi or I will have something in particular in mind, and then it's sort of, we'll get, I think, a lot of the songs will get a few sort of key phrases, and then everything else sort of follows and is based around those sort of key phrases, whether it's a story or just a train of thought or an experience or whatever. We usually just go from there.
Yes. What he said. What? It's a good image, though, the
finger down
the making you puke, yeah. Shallow Grave.
About Shallow Grave? Mm-hmm. About Elizabeth Short.
Right.
I mean, we know the Black Dahlia, mm-hmm. murders, the movie, mm-hmm. and her story, mm-hmm. but I can't remember the last time a song.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's not about Elizabeth. It's just sort of that concept of like achieving notoriety through the tragedy in your life.
Yeah.
You know, like someone who, for example, you know, they want to be something and they never quite achieve it, and then after
kind of a fallen wannabe starlet that becomes an icon because of
the horrible things that happen to them. Yeah.
We kind of like the idea of that. I have this book called Hollywood Babylon that sort of. Has a whole number of different stories sort of along that line.
And yeah.
Even when we were in college, that was something we were sort of interested in. And
yeah.
Yeah. Base some art around it and stuff like that. Yeah.
So, what's the crowd reaction to the new songs?
We've been playing four. We've been playing four of them on this tour for the last month.
It's been great. It's been the interesting thing was just this last tour we've been on, with the majority of it has been with OTEP. So I mean, it's the crowd itself has been, they've been more of a metal crowd. So our set is a little bit, we're kind of showcasing sort of the heavier side of the band. The set's like just sort of like an intense sort of 40-minute run through, and we picked the. Like probably the four sort of heaviest songs off of the last album to sort of showcase, and then a number of our other songs. So I think, I mean, the reaction's been great, but it's just sort of been that one select side of the album, which I think is, in a lot of ways, is sort of, I think a lot of people who've just heard those first songs assume that this album is sort
really
of a really sort of heavy,
different.
Crazy-driven album, but yeah, those are just the songs that we've been playing for.
So we would fit in with the heavy metal people.
The heavy metal crowd.
We didn't play Remember Me, for example.
We did not.
I don't think
no
that would have gone over.
Stevens, no tearjerkers.
No love songs.
Yeah, no lone tears.
Not quite.
No.
You have to, honestly, if you're doing a support gig, you know, and I mean, there's, you know, the Agonist, who are really tough, then Beneath the Sky are really tough, and then, you know, then us. It's like, you want to try and fit in with who you're playing to, and if you want to appeal to the, you know, you have to show that aspect of the band.
Exactly. But at the same time, you still want to give an honest representation of who the band is, and you don't want to sort of cater too much to one particular genre just to fit in, but yeah, we definitely just wanted the set to be exciting and just keep the pace of the whole show, because when you're playing with other bands, you want to carry the show, and you're part of, you know, every band together makes the show, you know, what it is. So we just wanted to pull our weight and do our job, you know.
Yeah. Yes.
Yes, yes.